Hey everyone, and welcome to this week's news coverage on all things World of Warcraft. Today, we'll be starting things off with looking at how leveling is in Shadowlands. As we know, Blizzard has made the leveling experience much less time-consuming, making it quicker to achieve the max level. Last week, Blizzard cut the experience needed from 50 to 60 by a huge margin for most of the levels. Due to this, they changed the experience acquired again, giving more total experience needed per level. At the same time, they also increased the experience per kill for each level as well. Overall, this may make leveling a tiny bit slower, but it will still be quick to get from level 50 to 60. We don't talk too much about the leveling process, but how do you guys feel about leveling? Do you prefer a long grind, doing tons of content, or do you prefer reaching max level as soon as possible? Speaking of people's thoughts on leveling, recently Ghostcrawler tweeted about his thoughts on leveling in the Shadowlands pre-patch. To be clear, he won't be back as a lead designer of the game, just as an avid World of Warcraft fan like all of us. Shadowlands has been looking great in the eyes of many, so it's no surprise to see it's persuaded plenty of people to get back into the game. Ghostcrawler has talked about his experience leveling a Rep Paladin, happy to see abilities that he designed are still in the game. He continues tweeting about his thoughts and observations throughout leveling, which makes for an interesting read, seeing how someone who designed the game feels about playing the game itself. It's a mix of in-the-moment thoughts as he's leveling, as well as seeing that game designer brain of his kick in, thinking about what could be changed. Most recently, Ghostcrawler also made a warrior to test out leveling in Mists of Pandaria once again. In similar fashion, he shares his thoughts while doing this on Twitter. Seemingly favoring melee specs, he decided to play as a Fury Warrior to see how it goes. He likes how the spec has changed over time, seeing new talents and updating the old ones to work well in current situations. He then continues with his thoughts on Mists of Pandaria as a whole. Personally, I find it quite fascinating to see his thoughts and would like to see more of them. It would be great to see what he does at level 60 in Shadowlands, and interesting to see if he does raiding, Mythic Plus dungeons, or maybe give PvP a shot as well. Next up, there's been quite a large number of changes for Soulbind Conduits and even the Soulbind Tree builds. The Soulbind Tree builds for every Covenant has been modified. While there are no new reworked Soulbind Conduits, the main change is that the Soulbind Trees are in a different order, typically reversing the order of your conduit choices. This means that we will be able to choose the more powerful abilities first, rather than acquiring them at the very end of the build. While this may seem like a small change, it can potentially make some tree builds stronger or weaker as the expansion starts. Here's an example from Venthyr, Nagia the Blademaster, comparing an old tree with the new layout. Although the tree changes were mainly just a rearrangement, on the other hand, Soulbind Conduits from all the Covenants got buffed by quite a margin. Feel free to check out all of these conduit changes on Wowhead. Mostly, they are small buffs to most of the Soulbind Conduits, which may change some of the tree decisions for some specs. Alright, now that we've covered the Soulbind Conduit and tree changes, we can now move on to the beta build, class, and spell changes. Before we get into that though, they've also updated the Covenant Renown UI in this build, allowing you to interact with an NPC to check your own renown levels. The new UI can show you every level and what you'll earn at each specific one. A bunch of interesting changes were made to class-specific Soulbind Conduits, Covenant abilities, as well as seeing a few PvP talent and spell changes. If you want to check out the full list of changes, feel free to browse this Wowhead page, if you don't want to miss out on anything. This is because we will only be covering the main highlights of these changes to classes or affected specs. Demon Hunters have been hit with quite big changes this build, receiving a big buff to the legendary item Chaos Theory. However, they also received a large nerf to Sinful Brand. Overall, these changes are nice for Demon Hunter, as having extra power to this legendary item will increase their single target pressure rather than having padded AoE damage from Sinful Brand. The numbers on Sinful Brand make it look like it could still have some weight to it, but it could be too weak. If that's the case though, then Demon Hunters could switch Covenants and look to become more powerful overall from these changes. As for Feral Druids, they only had one change, but it was a big one. Their staple PvP talent Ferocious Wound was nerfed. Since it requires 3 stacks to maintain on a target, it will be more difficult to maintain or to swap on other targets. The maximum health reduction effect was also dropped, so both effects of this PvP talent was nerfed. Even though this is a current staple PvP talent for Ferals, it may still stay this way due to it still being quite effective, as well as most other Feral PvP talents being hardly impactful. Next up, Hunters will also not be a fan of seeing this beta build, as their Flayed Shot took a massive blow, nerfing the damage of it to nearly a third of its original power. It's also had its chance to gain player's mark reduced, giving this Covenant ability a double nerf. Serpent Stalker's trickery was also changed, further nerfing the burst damage that Marksmanship Hunters could deal. Overall, these changes were needed, especially for Marksmanship Hunters as they were dealing absurd amounts of damage. It was straight up unhealable. The issue here is that we don't want to see Marksmanship become an extinct spec again like it was for the entirety of BFA. Although there is some hope still. If Flayed Shot is deemed too weak, then other Covenant abilities could replace it, such as Kyrian or Necrolord. Also, a new Hunter Finesse Conduit has been created, which could definitely be a nice little bonus in PvP situations. Unfortunately, the bad news continues for Rogues as well. Subtlety received some hefty nerfs with deeper daggers and perforated veins. These were powerful potency conduits for sub-rogues, so these nerfs will severely reduce their passive and burst damage. The change to perforated veins will also make it much more time consuming to ramp up the damage, as well as it being quite lackluster. Shadow Strike also received a nerf, changing it from a 25 yard range to melee. This will make it difficult for subtlety rogues to keep up the pressure while going for CC chains or generally on elusive classes. Assassination rogues also got hit quite heavily with nerfs, seeing their soulbind conduits getting nerfed hard as well. Ultimately though, I think that sub will still be more powerful than assassination. Sub was overtuned on the beta, so the nerfs to them will most likely mean that they stay top tier and not be too overpowered. Moving on, Shamans had quite a number of big changes across the board. Enhancement got some love from this beta build though, as Doomwinds got a crazy buff. It now has an added effect, increasing Windfury weapon damage by 100% as well. This combined with the Windfury weapon buff sounds like it will deal an absurd amount of damage, similar to the days of Legion, where Doomwinds would pack a serious punch. However, the love stops there as we see Earthen Harmony getting changed, which results in an overall nerf. This was definitely needed though, as it was dealing a crazy amount of free extra healing, so this was bad news for Resto and Ellie Shamans. But for once, Enhancement Shamans will be happy with these legendary changes. Alright, that covers all of the beta build highlights, allowing us to move on to the hot topic of PvE trinkets, specifically in this case the raid trinkets that have now been tuned. Before we get onto these changes, it's important to note that for a long time on the beta, these trinkets were working at 100% effectiveness in arena instances. This should not be the case, which is now so, nerfing all trinkets by 50% in arena on the beta. Overall though, most raid trinkets received a marginal buff, including Dreadfire Vessel, Manabound Mirror, and Skulker's Wing, which were all causing problems on the beta. However, due to the 50% nerf now working properly in arena, these trinkets are much less effective, but still seem quite good overall. Not to mention, there has been no talk about the PvP trinket set bonus, which in my opinion remains quite weak when compared with using PvE trinkets. Bearing in mind with the effectiveness of trinkets being nerfed overall, are you happy with these changes or would you want more to be done? Let us know in the comments below. Moving on to the pre-patch, one of the most awaited features coming up will be the Scourge Invasion events. This will include rare bosses that can drop 100 eye-level gear, which could help gear up alts that you may favor leveling in Shadowlands. Even though the dates of these events coming out are unknown due to the delay of Shadowlands, it is still worth knowing what these events can give you so that you can see if you need them in preparation for your characters in Shadowlands. Gear from Emissary Caches and Nazoth Assaults can drop up to 100 eye-level gear as well, making them a worthy feat if you need the gear. Also, completing the Legendary Cloak questline will be worth it for those characters that don't have it yet, as you'll be gaining an incredible amount of extra stats. Other changes include quite a big one for Mythic Plus fans, nerfing the explosives mechanic heavily. The HP of these mini explosives are so small that every class and spec should have access to an instant ability that can one-shot these explosives. Since they no longer scale with the level difficulty increase for Mythic Plus, these should be very easy to deal with and can be quite an interesting change to the Mythic dungeon scene. Speaking on the subject of PvE, a comparison has been made analyzing the rankings of classes, comparing their performance from Season 4 of BFA to the current pre-patch. For DPS specifically, there was a huge variety of changes for some specs across the board. This is what BFA Season 4 looked like, which as you can see gets drastically changed as the pre-patch hits. Some of the biggest changes include Shadow Priests, Elemental Shamans, and Unholy DKs rising to the top of the DPS spectrum. That being said, Arms Warriors, Demo Warlocks, and Demon Hunters were severely nerfed. These changes demonstrate the power Corruption Gear had over these classes, as well as the new changes affecting the other specs too. That being said, how do you all feel about Corruption becoming extinct in Shadowlands? Let us know your opinions down below. Alright, that covers all of the pre-patch news apart from one last thing. which is in the form of a pre-patch tournament. That's right. The organization Diabolus are putting together a pre-patch 3v3 tournament starting very soon. The offline qualifiers will start on the 26th of October. From that, there will be a top 8 live stream on the 7th and 8th of November for a chance to be a part of the 3,000 euro prize pool. This will probably be the last tournament of BFA as things get moving on with Shadowlands, and it could be interesting to see which compositions are performing the best during the pre-patch. Alright, now on to classic PTR testing. More Naxxramas testing has come out with the Abomination Quarter coming out on PTR. If you plan on testing this out and want to know more about the boss fights, then feel free to check out these WoWhead guides on their website in order to perform the correct strategy for each boss. That's not all though, as we see Blizzard adding the classic beta client to the Battle.net app. This may seem meaningless, but it could mean that Blizzard are preparing to use this in order to get Classic, the Burning Crusade, onto beta testing. Anyway, that brings us to the end of all things World of Warcraft in this weekly update. Don't forget to like this video if you enjoy, and feel free to ask any questions down below if you'd like. Thanks for watching everyone, and we'll see you next week.